Welcome to a confidence builder program on pointers. So this program is really going to help you completely have good clarity on what you have learned in the last 7 or 8 conceptual programs. So we'll go line by line so that we are able to understand the concepts clearly. So here I have defined int age is equal to 18. So what I can do is I'll draw a variable whose name is age, okay, whose value contained is 18, and let us say the address of age is 100. Now what I have done in the next line is I have drawn or I have declared SPTR, which is a pointer to an integer type of variable. Since it's a pointer, let me represent it in a square box so that we are very clear that it is a pointer type of a variable. What does it contain? It contains address of age. Since we have assumed the address of age to be 100, SPTR contains 100. But 100 is not a number, it's the address of this particular fellow age. Now let's say SPTR resides at a location 1000. Now, what I am going to do first is, I am going to simply print the age via the normal percentage d. So the output, if you look at it, let's say if this is the output window, I am going to have 18 printed first, which is the value of age. Then if I just print SPTR, it's going to print 100. The star tells me what is the value at address 100. The value at address 100 also happens to be 18. So this is how I take care of printing 18. Now what I have done in the next step is I have declared a pointer to a pointer. So what I am going to do is, since it's got two stars, I am going to represent it with a double square box so that this way you clearly know it's a pointer to a pointer. Let's give this fellow's name as DPTR. And let us say he resides at address 1004. This is just for conceptual clarity. Now this fellow cannot directly contain the address of age. Since it's a pointer to a pointer, it is going to contain the address of SPTR. What is the address of SPTR? It is 1000. So 1000 is contained here, as you can see in this particular assignment. Now, if I have to print the age by DPTR, the single star is simply going to print 1000, okay, it's going to print not 1000, the single star is going to print the address 100. Let me explain. If I simply print DPTR, the output is going to print as 1000, okay, whatever value it contains. Star DPTR, what is the content or value at location 1000? It happens to be address 100. So one star will print 100. Two stars will print what is the value at address 100. Value at address 100 happens to be 18. So now again I am going to have 18 printed using double star. Now let's play around with the triple star. We have triple star TPTR. So just to make it clear that it's a triple star, I am going to draw 3 boxes so that we don't get confused with what it is. So this way of representation is going to help you understand your concepts much better. Let us say this fellow is at 1008. Okay. Now, this fellow's name is TPTR, since it's a triple pointer. TPTR cannot contain SPTR or cannot contain the address of age. It can only contain the address of double pointer. What is the address of double pointer? It is 1004. So this fellow contains 1004. Now let us try to print age via the triple pointer. If I simply print TPTR, it will print 1004. First star will tell me what is the value or content at 1004. Value or content at 1004 is 1000. That is another address. Now when I apply one star to this 1000, it will tell me what is the value or content at 1000. It is 100. Now to this 100, when I apply the last star, what is the value or content at address 100? It happens to be 18. So 18 is again printed using the triple star. Now Let's try to print age by the address of TPTR. What is address of TPTR? It is 1008. Okay, this is 1008. The first star will give me the value at 1008. So what is the value at 1008? It gives me 1004. That is the first star has given me. The second star will tell me what is the value or content at 1004. The value or content at 1004 happens to be the address 1000. The third star will tell me what is the value or content at address 1000. It happens to be address 100. Now the last star will tell me what is the value or content at address 100. It happens to be 18. So the moral of the story is, don't get afraid with the number of stars. Just draw it diagrammatically for every variable, whether it's a pointer or a normal variable, give it values, give it addresses. Just be careful that all these pointer type of variables can only contain addresses. They cannot contain any values. So if it is one star, it means the first star will give you the age. Two star means the second star leads you to 18. Triple star means the third star leads you to 18. The last star will generally lead you to a integer character or a floating point value. If the last star is leading you to an address, then something in your concepts is not correct, or you have not done the representation correctly. So draw a diagram like this, do this program on your own, and if you are able to print all these results, then you have understood pointers really well.